exactly who Timmy Trumpet is.
Give it to him, Kurt. You got the trumpets, man. You got them Diaz trumpets hanging around. We got to dust them off in the closet. We got them, you know, and we got to get Diaz all set up. Who even have this series? What is it?
I don't even. They got the Colorado Rockies.
Oh, yeah. They got a four gamer against the Rockies. So Dibs didn't know who. Go ahead. Give it to me. There we go. There we go. Now you know. Well, you don't know yet. Wait for it. There you go. You know Timmy Trumpets. If you didn't know at the beginning of this season, you may have learned in May. If you didn't know by the All-Star break, maybe you learned in that Yankees-Mets two-gamer. If you didn't know after he broke your heart with the close, now you know, Dibs. When you hear this sound, you should get real tight and nervous because you're about to strike out. This is when Edwin Diaz is coming to save the day for the New York Mets. And this song, give it more. I want more. Put it more. There we go. This song is now the most feared song for 29 teams in Major League Baseball, and it's become so popular, Dibs, that just playing the song isn't cool enough. We gotta really get Timmy Trumpets in the building.
Okay, the name of the song is called Narco.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Did you even know that?
No, I didn't.
Okay, it's that. And Timmy Trumpet will be there Tuesday. I don't know.
Oh,
I had this written
Tuesday.
Down yesterday, so he's not gonna be so.
Just gonna, one day.
Timmy Trumpet's gonna be there one day because he's so popular. He's gonna throw out the first pitch.
Oh, cool.
Hang around. And have a microphone, I guess, around the eighth or ninth inning in case Edwin Diaz comes into the game. So if I'm the opponent, all I'm trying to do is beat down the Mets that one game so that Timmy Trumpet's not going to blow at the stadium right there.
And if you're
play the trumpet in front of you.
If you're the Rockies and you have like you're down four going into the
I don't think
the
it's
eighth.
The Rockies. I think they'll be out of town by then.
Oh, okay. Tuesday. Who
so
is
it's
it?
Tuesday.
Find out who it is.
I'll find out.
If you're down four and you know Timmy Trumpets and this whole thing's going to happen, if you have a save opportunity, do you maybe give up a couple of more runs for the Mets so Diaz is completely out of the picture?
It's the Dodgers.
Oh!
The plot thickens.
Oh!
The plot thickens is right.
So let me ask you this, Dibs.
And guess who returns to New York and has not pitched well since he left? Andrew Heaney.
Ooh, the Heaney man.
So he could give up a lot more than won't even be a save opportunity.
All right. So if you're the Dodgers, I doubt they play this way because they, you know, they actually want to win baseball games, unlike some of these.
They're not
teams.
Worried about the Mets or Timmy Trumpet.
If you have a 5-run cushion, 6, 7, 8.
Do you bring him in so Timmy Trumpet can play?
Does Buck Showalter do that kind of stuff?
It depends on if Edwin Diaz needs work. I was telling you about Soto for the Tigers. He came in a 5-run lead to get some work in yesterday. Kid throws 100 miles an hour. He's unbelievable. So this is the same thing with Diaz. He wants to pitch a lot every other day, almost every day. So if he doesn't pitch a few against Colorado, and probably most of these are going to be blowouts. And by the way, Monday's an off day for the Mets. So, he might not even pitch on Sunday or Monday and might need to pitch Tuesday in a blowout.
You don't like this, though. You
think I don't mind. I mean, I think it's you're
jumping the shark is what
you are. You're jumping. Thank you. You're jumping your the shark. You just you haven't won a playoff game this year. You haven't done anything other than, you know, play really well during the post the regular season. And you're only a game and a half in front of the Braves at this point. I mean, you could be down to like, you know, almost a tie situation in the National League East with the Dodgers. And now you're dragging Timmy Trumpet out to the ballpark to throw out the first pitch. What the hell did Timmy Trumpet do? Why is this guy rate a first pitch?
You know, when you put together.
He'd like win a gold medal or something like that.
He put together one of the best trumpet riffs of our lifetime.
That's exactly what he did. Even know it's him and not Chuck Mangione?
I think he's dead.
Oh,
what?
Chuck Mangione's
when
dead?
When did he die?
Yeah, I think you're right. I think he did pass
away. No way.
If he's still living, though, I would rather have Chuck Mangione play the.
I know Miles Davis passed away.
Damn.
Really?
So after you find that out, Kurt.
That's great.
We were talking during the break about Metallica and what they thought of Mariano's Enter Sandman coming out there. Now, I remember Metallica having a day at Yankee Stadium during the whole goodbye tour of Mariano Rivera. I don't remember if it was a save opportunity that day and if Metallica got on a stage somewhere in Yankees. You know, did that happen or not? Did we do that, Kurt? Do you remember this?
It did not happen.
It did not happen.
Chuck's alive. Chuck's alive. He's 81.
Chuck's 81. And he lives in Rochester, New York.
Oh, dude.
So he can just drive down and play anytime you want.
The former home of Bausch & Lomb.
He doesn't even need the notes. He can just hear this and like, all right, I got it.
I love me some Chuck Mangione, by the way.
Feels so good.
That's right.
We could have a little.
We could have a blow off here.
You could have a dueling trumpet.
Who's the better trumpet player right here?
Right field, left field.
Well, you know, a dance off from Starsky and Hutch.
I was thinking dueling, like the banjos, but yes.
Yes, dueling blow trumpets. Off,
I'm sure that's what they call it.
That's
the trumpet
exactly
world.
Exactly what they call it, the trumpet world.
It's one of the best things in baseball. It's one of the best things in baseball. I hope it happens.
But that's my point. It's a great story, but let's not go too far. Because then how disappointed would you be if the Mets don't go past the first round of the playoffs? And what are you going to do? Drag Timmy Trumpet out for the playoffs too?
Let me ask you this scenario. What if Timmy Trumpet comes out there and...
Oh, and he blows the save? I'm getting a new song. I'm shutting Timmy Trumpet
down.
Never
again for Timmy Trumpet's coming back?
Nah, I think, listen, Edwin Diaz, he struggled his first couple of years with the Mets. He's really happy where he is. I don't know if it's all about the song, but he gets pretty fired up about the song. I just watched somebody the other day. I don't know if it's the new closer for the Brewers or who it was, but that dude's got a little dance when he comes out of... This is Chuck Mangione. This is great.
This is not going to win the duel or the blow off. It's not going to.
No, this is not the song, though.
Give me about like 5 minutes.
Yeah, 5 minutes. It really heats up.
No, but the actual top 40 song.
There's that one.
Starts off pretty good.
And I think that when they play it on the radio, they cut into the good part.
That's what they do.
And they only play like. And this from sad movie. This is like a soundtrack,
some slow
right?
dance soundtrack.
I'll come back to it. When
you gotta come back with the top
Kramer
40
versus
version
Kramer
of that.
Soundtrack. Is that what this is?
That's like Old Yeller when Old Yeller dies. Sending him off with a little bit of doesn't feel so good right now.
It's like you try telling old Timmy Trumpets about Chuck Mangione. He's like, oh yeah, what song? And then wait, Timmy, sit down until you hear this one. Remember when Old Yeller got put to sleep?
Still playing like some kind of... this is like when Rocky was on Hard Times.
Oh, I was thinking it's like Rocky. Like when 5. You squeeze a balloon and you let the air out of it.
Mangione is going to get blown out if he shows up on Tuesday to challenge
That's
Timmy.
That's not Trumpet. The song I remember. That's like the elevator version of Feels So Good by Chuck Mangione.
New York Mets fans, like if he came out, if people don't know Chuck Mangione, Google him real quick, and I'm sure the first Google image will be him holding his little trumpet with a smile.
He's a Grammy Award winner, by the way.
Oh, he's in the trumpet world, he's number one. But no one will know who the hell he is. Everyone will be like, who's this joker who brought it? This is Timmy Trumpet's day, dude. Get out of here. Oh, it's Chuck Mangione. Chuck who? Get out of here, Chuck.
It's a little bit more up-tempo.
No one is using this as their walkout.
It picks up another notch.
Oh, I'm sure.
In another probably 7 minutes.
Give it 7 minutes, and it really gets going. No, this would be such reverse psychology. Like, you walk in.
This is what we should be playing in the other locker room.
It's like, all
right. Right before the game, let's just.
Now entering the game.
Pipe that in.
Number 49, Rob Dibble.
I was up at the Big E, the old, where the Springfield, what they called Indians at the time, the AHL franchise. They were warming up to Mas Area More from Stevie Wonder, and I couldn't understand the really mellow warm-up music. It just didn't make any sense to me.
Still a little less mellow than this one, though. Like, this is not getting anyone hype.
Really? I'm ready
listen to this.
I'm ready listen to fight to right song. Now.
But listen to that, how high he gets right
now. Oh, yeah, this is where it is.
Yeah. Can Timmy Trumpet get up that high?
This is where he wins the blow-off.
Yeah. This is where his cheeks are out like Louis Armstrong. Oh, yeah.
No one brings back Chuck Mangione quite like the Rob Dibble Show.
This is the weirdest show ever. No one does.
We went from Timmy Trumpet to Chuck Mangione. That's why I love doing this job. You never know what we're going
to
do on this show.
I don't want to tell people to Google it because I feel...
No.
Like, you're never going to trust me to have you Google anything.
This guy was fabulous, 60s, 70s, 80s. He was one of the best jazz trumpeters out there.
My grandparents loved him.
Like Miles Davis.
Grandparents loved him.
There you go.
They're from New York, so.
And he's from New York. So, all right. So, Timmy Trumpet.
Big day.
We think it's jumping the shark.
Big day on
Tuesday. What
do you think? I think it's fine. I think it's great. I can't wait. I hope it's the same.
Because I think it could jinx you. I think it could jinx you, you know? That's why. All right. So when we were in Cincinnati after we won the World Series, they used to play this on the board. Anytime Norm, Randy, or myself came out of the bullpen, they would play like highlights from the year before. And we made them stop because I'm like, why are you playing that stuff? You're just going to like upset the other team to where they really want to kick the crap out of us. Stop playing highlights from the World Series. That was old news. You know, let's not do that. And they were like, oh, well, you know, we don't need to play that kind of stuff. So you don't need to rub it in somebody's face is what I'm trying to say.
It could be a thing. I mean, I'm fearful that it will turn into a blown save and that he won't be right ever since Timmy Trumpets showed up on that Tuesday. Yeah, it's risky. You're really rolling the dice here. With
distraction.
A little distraction.
All right.